Sometimes there are moments where you think, well, why am I doing this? It seems that I will never be perfect. It's impossible to become perfect, a perfect chess player, and it's impossible to make only perfect chess moves. There are always moments when you lose a game and you're not able to do anything. And in this moment, I ask myself, why am I doing this? My name is Alexandra Kostyniuk. I came from Russia, Moscow. I'm a chess player, professional chess player. I started to play chess at the age of 5. My father taught me how to play chess.
So I was watching my father playing chess with his friends. And then I just got interest to play chess, and my parents were a little bit afraid because I was too little, but when I became 4 and a half, then even before, then they decided that it was probably time to show me the rules. And I must say that at that moment I realized all the rules myself, but still it was important that my father just repeated this lesson, how rules are in chess.
I'm 21 and I started to play chess when I was 5, and my father was teaching me since he was an active player in the 1980s, 1990s, and then when I was 5 and my brother was, and then at this time 7 years old, he was just taking us to tournaments and he taught us chess and he gave up his career just for us.
No, mi chiamo Mark, sono un irlandese, sono di Dublino, nato, cresciuto lì. Praticamente ho scoperto il mondo degli scacchi quando avevo 6-7 anni, che ero in Inghilterra. Mia sorella è un musicista, concertista del pianoforte, e io ero lì che le facevo sempre i concorsi e ero completamente annoiato. Poi ho scoperto che c'era questo gioco meraviglioso che si chiama gli scacchi. E poi quando ho scoperto che c'era uno scacchiere dove eravamo, ho fatto il cattivo per tanti giorni, dicendo a mio padre, se non mi insegni, urlo sempre, quindi mi ha insegnato come giocare lui, anche se lui non giocava. Ha utilizzato un libro, lui, che ha letto, mi ha fatto le prove, e poi quando abbiamo finito quel libro, sono andato a un circo degli scacchi. Quindi.
My father, he taught me when I was 13, and after I got a coach from Ecuador, and I started playing many tournaments.
Ho cominciato a giocare ai 12 anni, cioè le regole le ho sempre sapute circa, si sapevano a casa e basta. E poi mio padre mi ha accompagnato a un torneo di scacchi, perché secondo lui non facevo un cazzo, stavo nei bar, giocavo ai videogiochi e mi ha portato a questo torneo di scacchi e ho cominciato a giocare, bello.
So I, from the beginning, I didn't like to lose, and even I was crying for several times, and then my father said that if I would cry once more, then he will stop to play with me, and so this was a big threat. And then I decided that I should keep my nerves and I should play without crying.
Terribile, anche perché probabilmente, a parte la quantità di ore che stai lì compresso, in qualunque altro sport più fisico comunque c'è uno sfogo. Sai, il pugile tira cazzotti, un calciatore corre da un calciapallone all'avversario, qualcosa succede, il ciclista pedala, se proprio a quel punto ti senti talmente carico pedali più forte, qual è il problema? Il tennista spara mazzate su una palla, e qua bisogna starsene buoni e tranquilli e concentrati, e a volte sfoga veramente solo dentro, che è devastante questo.
It's really getting on your nerves. It's taking a lot of your nerves, and so you have to be very clear. You have to keep the concentration. It's really it's a hard game in some way, because you have to be concentrated all the time, and it takes a lot of your energy. You realize that usually always at the end of the tournament you are very tired. Some people get even sick and stuff, or they come home very pale on the face and just feeling weak and out of energy.
That's why a lot of chess players try to do some exercises, you know, to, like, I don't know, run or be in a good physical shape, because it's very important, you know, because otherwise it's very hard. Chess is very stressful. That's why a lot of people quit, you know, because after many years, you know, the nerves are not so good anymore, because it's a lot of stress. I think there are other sports are not as stressful, because when you're playing for so long for yourself, you know, it's very hard. And when you play soccer or tennis, you know, you're moving a lot, you know, so it's healthy. But when you play chess, it's not so healthy. You sit like this, you know, for many hours, it's very hard.
Queste due partite al giorno, per me in particolare, sento che sono massacranti. Magari altri reggono molto meglio. E poi arrivano, ci sono anche partite che non sono così tanto impegnative. Quando non c'è troppo da calcolare, o, cioè, dipende anche da quanto conosci la posizione che stai giocando. Sono partite che veramente sei là sotto per due ore concentratissimo, poi ti stacchi un attimo e non so, torni alla scacchiera e ti accorgi che chiaramente hai le allucinazioni, non riesci più a ragionare, non riesci più a seguire.
For chess players, physical conditions are extremely important. Because if you have any problems with nerves, or physically you are not feeling well, then you simply cannot keep concentration for hours. And the chess game is when you play with equal opponent or on the top level, then chess game can continue till 6-7 hours, and it seems to be long, but each minute, I can't say each second, but sometimes even each second can be decisive. So you must keep concentration during all this time. And if you have problems with health, simply you cannot achieve success in chess.
Gli scacchi ti insegnano la responsabilità che ogni mossa ha la sua, diciamo, cioè l'effetto è a causa praticamente, che quando fai qualcosa, quando sbagli praticamente e tu perdi, è colpa tua, tu puoi migliorare il gioco dopo, però dipende su di te, quindi tu puoi perdere una partita per diversi motivi. Però quando sei un giovane, molto, molto giovane, di imparare questa lezione che nella vita si vince e si perde, ci vuole essere umile quando vinci, anche diciamo di essere felice quando perdi, questo è di vivere.
Gli scacchi è un problema complesso, nel senso che tu utilizzi l'analisi, però non puoi mai essere esaustivo completamente nella tua analisi. Esattamente per esempio come nell'economia. Nell'economia tu hai possibilità di analizzare molte componenti, però non sei mai sicuro al 100% come nella scienza di arrivare a una soluzione esatta del problema. Sono i famosi problemi complessi. Gli scacchi è uno di questi problemi complessi e ti fa acquisire queste capacità che sono utilissime in altri campi.
Develops their minds, their logic, their creativity and a lot of new things, and I believe that chess, there is a place for chess in the school program, and I think chess should be included in the school program.
Ma è una cosa fondamentale, diciamo, nella mia vita, che che ho imparato tantissimo dal Vito, ho incontrato un sacco di persone, anche perché il bello del gioco è che non è solo uno sport, però c'è un piacere estetico quando stai giocando, che uno di 6 anni e uno di 60 possono condividere la stessa gioia. Quindi è una cosa che supera i confini dell'età, anche di cultura, di lingue.
Chess has its own language. You know, there's a chess notation that you don't have to speak English, Russian, Spanish or Italian. I mean, with this notation, everybody can understand each move because the board has, each square has a name. So that's why you can see in tournaments, two players analyzing a game and they don't speak the same language, but they can understand, you know, the moves.
Chess is a special language, and so this is like language which everybody knows. And let's say chess is maybe like Esperanto, and people who know how to play chess, they can communicate each other by internet or in real life.
Go on, give up self-control, troll.
I was for half a year, I was a pupil of his school. And so Botvinnik always was saying that chess, you can imagine chess as a philosophical problem. And so if you develop your mind, if you develop your philosophical ideas, then you can deeper understand chess.
Però un modo di calcolo non del tutto analitico, c'è anche una componente, diciamo, artistica, nel senso che tu devi cercare di capire come i pezzi sono ben coordinati fra di loro. Quindi a un certo punto valuti anche in maniera, diciamo, estetica la posizione. Tu calcoli alcune mosse avanti, poi dici lì come sto, starò bene in questa posizione o male. E questo lo puoi calcolare, lo puoi capire soltanto con una, quasi sentendo che le cose sono, i pezzi sono in maniera, posti in maniera armonica.
The pieces tell me, please free me when I have a piece that's not developed or a piece is out of the game. I think it's very unfair for that piece, so I try to bring it to the game. They don't really speak, but it's like I always try to help them, I don't know, somehow.
I think they mean, what they mean is intuition or pattern recognition, which happens with a lot of people. Like you play your game, it happens with me actually all the time. You play your game, but you feel inside that you already played this. You already have seen this.
Before every move, you need to do some kind of choice. And we can't say that the game of chess is a game of how you make this choice, because in this, you make choice. If it's right, you sometimes win. And if it's a bad choice, you can lose. So, well, you just, first of all, you try to understand which move is better. You try to calculate some variations. If you cannot, you are not able to calculate and to understand which move is better, you just rely on your intuition, because I've been playing chess for many years, and intuition depends on your experience. Sometimes you just make your move, and then it happens as this move is a very good one. And many ask, why did you make this move? And say, well, I don't know, it seemed for me that this move would be better. So just intuition, experience, and of course, some kind of calculation.
La preparazione non è solo allenarsi e studiare, no, noi siamo obbligati a studiare e ricercare cose nuove, è quello il punto, dobbiamo anche sforzarci di essere creativi, quindi oltre che lo scacchista è musicista e compositore nello stesso tempo, secondo me.
There was one funny story about a man called Velimirović from Yugoslavia, and this was told to me by the Yugoslavian team. It was just when the Americans started to bomb Yugoslavia, was the first round of the Yugoslav championship. And so they are sitting there in front of the board about to play, and all of a sudden they hear explosions, like boom, 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 in the background. And everybody is looking around what's happening. And Velimirović called the arbiter. Arbiter. The arbiter comes up. Velimirović asks him, what is the time control in this tournament? Absolutely wasn't paying any attention to his city being bombed. He just wanted to know how much time he had to play the game. So really, if you have the concentration, you literally don't hear the bombs, as this example shows. If you're playing well, if you're playing badly, then if you're not concentrated, then you are disturbed by somebody drinking water two tables away. And if something disturbs you like this, then you know it's not a good day for you. So you have to get in this zone where you don't hear, you don't see, you don't smell nothing. And it is a type of meditation when it's good.
You know, you only have the pieces, you have the chessboard, and you're a commander. Whatever you do, I mean, you'll get what you do. And there is no place for, I don't know, just words. You have actions, and you are able to prove whatever you want to prove. So
sempre nel gioco degli scacchi c'è risoluzione, diciamo, si vince, si perde, fai pareggi, però nella vita tanto spesso non c'è risoluzione nei rapporti, anche nell'ambito di lavoro iniziamo tante cose. La cosa più difficile secondo me nella vita, quindi non è che sono filosofo molto saggio, però io ho sempre pensato che la cosa difficile è di portare alla fine una cosa che tu hai iniziato, però col gioco degli scacchi questo succede sempre, ogni giorno è una nuova partita.
A lot of people have said, and it's true, that I believe that, you know, chess is just small, you know, example of life, because you also live, you know, like in the game, you know, it's a long game, you know, you play like life, right? You learn and you keep going, and you have to, sometimes you have to sacrifice something in order to get something, right? You have to lose something to achieve something. And sometimes it's better to, you know, instead of going forward, you know, go back sometimes and think, you know, to make some strategy, decide what you want to do, because there are a lot of plans in chess, you know, it's not that only one way to win. No, it's not like that. You know, there are a lot of different ways you can go when you play chess, you know? And it's very important to make a right choice. Like in life, you know, you have many opportunities, but you have to make sure you make the right choice in order to, you know, get where you want to go. So that's why, you know, I think chess and life are very close to each other, because, you know, in chess, if you make a wrong choice, you make a bad plan, you lose your game. And the same in life, you know? you lose the life and it's over, you know, the life is gone. But in chess, you know, you come back.
Because chess is a very creative game and you can just develop your plans and in this game. It's like, you know, in real life we cannot always do what we want, but on the chess thing, in the chess way, we can just make our own plans, our own decisions without being responsible. Okay, when we make a mistake, we lose. But in life, sometimes to make this risk has much, much worse consequences, like to put money on some wrong account, and not only you lose your money, it's much worse than to lose a chess game, I think.
Sì. È molto facile fare confusione, però. Però c'è molto da capire, da imparare. Come aiuto, no? Come applicazione. Cioè, gli scacchi ti aiutano a ragionare in una maniera utile, però essendo anche una cosa abbastanza... Cioè, non deve diventare un tutt'uno, cioè il modo in cui pensi, c'è molti così, il modo in cui pensi agli scacchi lo pensi alla vita, no? È complicata sta cosa. Poi anche questo, no? Scacchi, c'è un avversario comunque, cioè tu fai la tua parte, ma... Altrettanto dipende da cosa sta facendo l'altro, no? In linea di massima. Ma chi è questo? Cioè, questo avversario mica c'è nella vita.
Many years ago, there was a difference, again, before the internet age, and women used to, like in tennis, where in the 70s women were doing moon balls backwards and forwards. You look at women playing tennis now, it's this much above the net, and they play fantastic tennis. Now also women play fantastic chess. Not so many. And one reason is just lack of interest.
One difference is for sure that every woman when you're beginning, I think it's my opinion, just when you're just starting to be 20 and getting older, you just think about family and getting kids and all this stuff. For men it's not the same. Men can fix on one thing much, much more easier than women. Just women are too emotional. We cannot just fix on chess. We have to do some other things around. I cannot imagine that anybody can just fix on one thing without thinking about other things. It's not in our nature just to fix on one thing since we are women and we have this family thing inside us. I think it's just a biological matter. That's one reason why men are just better than women in chess, because they can easily just fix on chess without having anything around them. A woman is impossible. The other thing is just that men are much more aggressive than women. They are born much more aggressive, and I think in chess it's sometimes important to take some risk and to be much more ambitious and to have this aggressivity. For women, it's because of the nature, not so possible.
Women don't don't like to dedicate their whole time to chess, you know? They like other things in life too, you know? They don't want to spend so many hours studying as men. So that's another reason why men are doing better in chess than women, because, you know, women go shopping, you know? They like to, you know, have more friends and, you know, do hair and makeup, you know? But men, you know, are more serious and more focused on chess, so, yeah.
Because girls under the age of 10, in my opinion, I haven't done a statistic on this, but in my opinion, they can concentrate on even better than young boys. But the problem is that when they reach 12 or 13, girls seem to be completely distracted. They lose complete interest, absolute complete interest, while boys change from the silly little boys to complete concentration on something, football, tennis, chess, video games. They become, boys when they become teenagers become obsessive, and girls tend to be interested in other things.
And only in 1980s, women started playing chess professionally and seriously. So women play chess only 30 years professionally, and men have been playing chess many, many years. So it's just a question of time, I think, first of all, because I don't see why women should be weaker than men in chess. Of course, men have some pluses, they will play a little bit stronger, but the difference between women and men should not be so big as we are seeing right now. So it will change, and I think in 10 years it will be many more women grandmasters, and the difference will become smaller. So it's just a question of time.
Adesso col computer puoi analizzare anche prima della partita molte varianti in profondità, è diventato molto più analitico, le varianti sono molto più concrete. Si chiama, non lo chiamo un gioco tattico, ma sono varianti concrete, quindi è il modo in cui gioca il computer non ha questa capacità che dicevo prima di natura estetica, quindi lui analizza in maniera concreta le varianti. E adesso i giovani che sono formati studiando col computer hanno acquisito anche il loro stile di gioco. E quindi è proprio esteticamente sembra di giocare veramente un altro gioco. E anche dal nostro punto di vista di giocatore di una certa generazione piace di meno.
Of course we all use computers, but when we analyze, when we are on a camp or somewhere with friends, we try to minimize the level of computer assistance. Just only final checkup with computer, just to see if tactical things are not being out.
Nessuno si avventurava in varianti complicate e rischiose, perché non c'era il controllo prima, mentre adesso tu lo puoi fare questo controllo prima della partita in certe varianti e andare magari 25-30 mosse in posizioni complicatissime e analizzarle col computer. Arrivare alla scacchiera e già avere un'idea di come potrà svilupparsi il gioco. Quindi ti fidi a fare cose che una volta non ti saresti fidato.
Molto diverso, tu avevi una variante che conoscevi, ma e con quella giocavi, magari vincevi 10 partite, perché tanto nessuno o quei pochi solo addetti ai lavori la conoscevano, ma poi ci vivevi di rendita. Adesso tu magari hai un'idea fantastica, innovativa, bella, vincente, però la gioco stasera e stasera dopo un quarto d'ora lo sanno tutto il mondo.
Right now you look at positions, people play positions which no one would play before, because chess becomes very defensive, and you grab a pawn and you sit and wait for 20 moves. So before, chess was much less materialistic in a way. So yeah, and people learn to defend with computers.
Yeah, okay, I'm also working with computers. Of course, everybody is working with computers. It's easier. It just gives a position. You ask the computer and it tells you like this, this, and this, and this. You're just getting too lazy to analyze by yourself and to find the things if the computer can tell you in seconds, you know, it's normal. because this new generation is used to work with computers, so it's much easier and they're much faster than if you analyze very deeply.
Negli ultimi anni c'è un'esplosione di giovani di livello assoluto, proprio a 12-13 anni già grandi maestri, cosa che ai tempi di Fischer lo è diventato grande maestro a 15 anni e sembrava una cosa irraggiungibile, fatta da un genio che irripetibile. Invece adesso praticamente ogni settimana, ma con una frequenza incredibile, escono in tutto il mondo, dalla Norvegia all'India, alla Cina, nuovi talenti, uomini e donne che insomma hanno risultati incredibili. Questo grazie col computer e i programmi che ci sono, i programmi sia di gioco che di archiviazione.
Chess, it's like, you know, language between two people. It's a battle between two people, two intellectuals. So I like chess because very much because, you know, you have 64 squares, you have pieces on the board, and you can prove anything you want to prove. And it doesn't matter who is in front of you. You just play, do your best, and you're a winner or a loser, and it depends on you, totally on you.
Chess player have to have a fighting spirit. This is, he can know all the theory in the world, he can be a machine calculating, I don't know, but if a player gets a bad position and he's not a fighter, he will lose easily. So I think one very important element is never to give up in a game, just to try all the time.
For 2 years, good money every month they pay you, and you can just play chess without worrying about the financial point. But on the other hand, I would have maybe done it nevertheless, even without the money point, just to see how it is, because it's a good experience to go to the army, because sometimes you have to go on your limits, you know, like physically and psychologically. It's sometimes you come in situations where you don't know yourself, you just learn about yourself much better when you are in some extreme situations, like in the army. Like sometimes they woke us up at 3 o'clock and we had to go to the forest at 3 in the morning, and it was just tired and didn't shower and everything, and they just tried to I don't want to say fuck you here, but that's what they was trying. That was saying how when we give up, when we just resign, you know. It's a matter like to feel how strong are you as a person.
Well, I remember when I was playing in this category tournaments. We have it in Soviet Union. You see, you have to fulfill this category, that category, just to play with other guys. And I was playing second category tournament, and one guy was crushing me, absolutely crushing me. And then that day he told me, why don't you resign? And I almost died at that moment. This is what I remember, because I was full of tears, you see. This is the childhood I remember. And what I remember from this story, on the next day I was playing with a guy, I took all his pieces, almost everything. And then at one moment he wants to castle. He touches his rook first. And I told him, no, no, no. If you touch your rook, you're gonna play your rook. No way you're going to castle. So I became like very strict, you see, at that moment. So chess is wild and game.
No, I remember when I was a kid, you know, my parents were very scared because at night I would talk in my sleep. And I would say like e4 or knight c6, you know, castle, you know. My parents were like, you know, maybe it's not for her. Maybe it's time to quit, you know. They were scared. But, you know, I think it's normal because you think so much about the game. You play so long, you know, your brain's still working, you know. So, and you also, it's a lot of stress to play chess. So sometimes when I go to sleep, yeah, I see some variations, some positions, you know?
Sono molto, cioè è vero, potenzialmente sono più pericolosi di altre cose, no? Perché è proprio mentale, non c'è un equilibrio tra il corpo e la mente, queste cose. Però sono stati inventati, una ragione ci sarà, forse è un mezzo che deve essere espanso, poi ancora non sappiamo perché.
questa è la cosa che dispiace più negli scacchi, che una vittoria non controbilancia una sconfitta, cioè il dolore che ricavi da una sconfitta è molto più grande dal piacere che ricavi anche da due vittorie. E sì, è dura per tutti gli scacchisti, soprattutto quando sprecano una posizione vinta. Allora lì veramente a volte ci pensi tutta la notte, anche il giorno dopo. Ci sono certi che ci pensano, continuano a parlarne anche dopo anni.
Chess is a very hard game. You can be winning all the time, and then you make just one mistake and you lose a game. It's just like, you know, you are athletics and you run like 100 meter and 10 meter before the goal you're just falling. It's very unlikely in athletics, but in chess it's just like that. One, you can just have a perfect position and then one move and everything is over. That's a bad thing about chess, it's sometimes very painful.
L'importante invece è cercare di avere un distacco abbastanza, cioè una volta fatto è fatto, capire che in fondo gli scacchi è un gioco basato sugli errori, sia propri che dell'avversario, quindi che l'errore fa parte dell'attività, è una parte essenziale dell'attività, quindi bisogna accettare anche i propri errori.
It's very hard, you know, like when you win, you know, you, especially if you win very important match, you know, you just feel so happy, you know, you, I don't know, probably the happiest you have ever felt, you know. I remember a lot of chess players say when they win big tournament, they say, oh, this is happiest day of my life, you know. You know, sometimes people say they, when they get married, you know, it's my happiest day, or when they have a baby, but the chess players, when they win, you know, it's my happiest day. So you just feel very happy, you know, and you feel smart and you feel proud of yourself, you know, and that's a very good feeling.
Like sometimes you're on the winning streak and then suddenly you make some mistakes and you don't win anymore. Of course the feeling is much clearer because you saw you could have won, you know, because in chess it's much more cool because the result is not so clear from the beginning because everything can change in the last moment. That's a problem basically. So the mood is, I think, in this way much more dependent, like in other sports. It's much more sensitive game than other things, I think.
Now, when you lose, on the other hand, you know, it's very hard. I know a lot of chess players cry, and it's normal, you know, for a chess player. You know, I remember once when I was a kid, you know, I lost a very important game, and I was so upset. You know, I went out in the park next to the chess playing hall, and I started to cry, you know, the tears coming down, you know, I cry so hard, and my friends are behind me, you know, and they don't want to come close because, you know, they don't know what to say, you know, and people are walking in the park, you know, so they see me cry, you know, and they go to my friends, what happened, did someone die, you know, did her mother die or father? No. What happened, did her boyfriend leave her? No. Then what happened, you know, she lost a chess game. What? That's why she's crying? They thought I was crazy, you know? But you know, you put a lot of emotions in this game, you know? Like you try so hard, you know, for so long, and when you lose, you know, it's very painful. You know, you can play 6 hours really well, you know? You can be winning, and then in one move, you can lose, you know?
I mean, some people take their losses easily, their wins like something big happened. But it was always with me that I was, after I started to win some tournaments, it went like I wasn't really feeling so sorry for losing anymore and so happy for winning. I don't know. It went a little bit different. So less emotions. But what really inspires me, that's how my family and all friends of mine are really, really getting very emotional about my wins, and that's a good part of it.
Any people sometimes have good moments, sometimes have bad moments, but really great athletes and chess players, they know how to go ahead after the defeats. And so the most important thing when you lost a match, lost a game, played badly in a tournament, just analyze why did this happen and just stand up and go ahead. Work on yourself, work on chess, and be stronger than all the defeats you had.
freedom.